Calibre, the Fratpack of one half Fratpack. This is what it is right here on Black Nation TV. It's great!
Black Nation TV.
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 Yeah. What the message is that it's the biggest thing. Like, it might be corny to some people because they've heard it so many times, but it's so hard to practice. What we're trying to say is that it's okay to be you in any way or form. It's okay to express yourself, you know, and that's the number one thing that we want to do. We want to make it cool to express yourself the best way you know how. And the best way we know how is through rap. And the fact that we love rap, we want to rap as good as possible. You know, if you love math, you want to get the highest mark. So with us, because we love rap, we want to rap the best, basically. And but the message through it is this, like, if you love something, express it. And just express yourself, express your emotion through art, you know, and any art medium. The art medium that we chose is music, so it's really just about expressing yourself, and we do it through bars, man. And again, it's just something that's missing right now, that we think that people aren't catering to that, like really witty bars and just like lengthy bars, you know? There are people that still love to read novels, you know what I mean? Big novels. And like there's people, if there's people like that, then there's definitely people that want to listen to full songs and full lyrics. And we cater to people that want to listen to full lyrics and where 16 bar is packed, you know? So content is what we giving people, because we feel like content is sort of missing. So that's what we're doing, and that's what we're trying to achieve with what we're doing. And definitely the performance art of everything. To give you an experience through the performances. And we've been blessed to have people like Tamba, people like Dale to support us, you know what I mean? Because those are people that are really, 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 really good at what they do. And it's awesome that they're down to mess with us. Fratpack. And that was just, you know, it really is an intro song. And it made sense for us to perform that song first because it teaches you how to spell the name. A lot of people still get the name wrong, and we figured that we take it into our own hands and teach people how to say the name and spell it out as well. That's why the chorus goes Fratpack, one word, one unit, you know? Because people always like separate the words, some funny stuff like that, just showing the backpack is one word. And then after that, we went to Out Here, which is quite big. Now Dale was like, while we were doing it, practicing it, he was like, dude, why are you performing the song so early in the set? Because it's such a big song. And when you listen to the song, like, you can hear it, so much a drummer can do with the songs. So it made sense for it to be in the beginning. And said those sneaker deals by playing rock, paper, scissors. It's about to be. Yeah, feeling like I belong in straight jackets. He's telling me I got the crazy habits. My boy Rory, I'm such a coke addict. No, not the powder, I take too much acid. Two drug lines, hope you can catch it. See the flow is heavy like the rhymes in my baggage. Big problem, you can't even fathom. Fly rocks, jet lag when I start rapping. The song, first song, I think that really, really made people pay attention to us, because we got that onto hype sessions, you know. So people were like, okay, this is a really, really funky beat, it's a funky track, and the fact that the lyrics are so dope made people love them. And that one was just like out of pure wit. All of that was just wit. The title of it, Better Than Your Life, was just something I liked saying on Twitter. And Gito was like, yo man, come on, let's do this, you know, let's make it a hook, let's do something, you know? And the beat was from BFG, you know, from Brassol and Soul Factor, and then they sent us the beat, and then magic happened.
Literally don't wait on anybody. We record ourselves, yeah. Shoot our own videos, and we say, hey Kelsey,
put us on radio. And yeah, she does. She's amazing. When you're
off the bomb.com, we went into the two songs that we did individually on the tape. So we start with Quito's 2 Chainz, which is Quito being a mature figure and at a mature age, and you're dabbling into rap where other people figure rap as something childish or whatever, you know what I mean? But Quito's showing me the mature way of rapping and the fact that, you know, it's a passion and rap is a genre, you can grow with it. And that's basically what that song is showing you. Positive vibes, that's my Fratpack of heart. Love stick rhymes, that's that backpack of heart. Could give a 40 case about your little rapper chart. 1/2 my IQ, man, you have a smart. I'm not infatuated about being hated. I'm here to rap, not get my ego inflated. A poor movie that's PG, I'm underrated. And they as basic as big letters with finger spaces. But I'm not tripping though, this is a boarding pass. An error in this era, we're too emphatic tabs. A repetition of experiments in black labs. Add a white those samples to that beat, yo. Spit that Versace and never reference Migos. No challenge, they play it with some... The worlds of television and music, when they meet, what happens? So that's why I made Jam Ellie, as well as just throwback in the second verse of how things were and how things are now, basically, you know, in terms of the music spectrum. The first verse is just really about, you know, life. It's a very personal song because I actually reference personal things, you know, like the fact that my brother gave me a car when I didn't have anything, you know what I mean? Like, I didn't have mode of transport when I got out of varsity. And he helped me up, he was just like, yo, fix it up, you know, it's a bit rusty here and there, you know, so just little things like that. And the fact that I've got a law degree and I work in TV, like, you know, those worlds, people don't understand it, but it's life, it's reality. And that, the special thing about it was DJ Tamba there, you know, the minor scratches that he did on set there was crazy, you know, because now you've got the turntables and you've got the drums, and they're not badly, but they're kicking ass together. It's like Cadillacs and Dinosaurs, where you have Jack and Mustafa, and they just kicking dinosaurs right, left, and center, and crooks. So that's how the turntables and drums were interacting there. The whole idea of live streaming on radio and performing at the same time is just something that's really, really dope. And we couldn't do it because in order for you to do Live and Rewired, you have to have a live act with you. You know, it has to be some sort of a band or instrumentation some way, somehow. They don't allow just DJ and an MC. They don't allow that. So we were fortunate enough to bump into Dale, and we were doing this interview with Dale on Art Life Radio, and he mentioned that he'd love to do like some Travis Barker type stuff, you know, like drum for rappers, you know. And I was like, man, we're looking for a drummer, you know. We want somebody to like add on to the sound of Fratpack, and we have this Live and Rewired thing that's dwindling, and we need a live element, you know, in order for us to qualify to be on Live and Rewired. And he was just like, yeah, man, if I can drum the songs, then let's do it, you know? So I sent him a couple of songs, we sent him a couple of songs, and he could do them, and he listened to them, and he's like, these are great songs, so let's actually do it. And that's how we got onto the platform. And then, like, the track list, if you think about it, it's really, really us just taking you through the journey of the EP, the Fam Love EP. We basically performed almost every song of the EP.
That's 016. That's that 06. It's that 016. It's that 016. Yo, I really got lost in my feelings on that one, because the homie I'm talking about in that verse is right here.
If we ever just something else, man, it's... We got the beat from a friend of mine, Lou, who's manager for rap and manager for Louis London as well. And he was working on a music project, you know. And he was like, dude, I've got these beats and please tell me what you can do with them, you know? And it was a kid called Gamudia, something like that. Like, his name is Gamudia, and he had done the beat. And when I heard it, it was just like, wow, man, this is, you just need to rap here and forget anything else, forget whoever, you know what I mean? So that's why the title is If We Ever. You know, this is just bars, 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 which is basically the favorite song there in YFM, because they love, they play this, the song, and Paniel, who's one of the people in charge of Live in UY, loves the song. And the funny thing about it is that that song almost didn't make the set, because like, we had no games in place of that.
Real talk, we get it in. Not knowing whether or not we'll win, but not using this kind of talent would probably be a sin. You think that we just begin, but already 3 mixtapes in, the amount of hours put in make you pale in comparison. Frat, sick of telling y'all about the level that we on. If you haven't seen by now, then there's nothing we can agree on.
Literally don't wait on anybody. We record ourselves, yeah. Shoot our own videos, and we say, hey Kelsey, put us on radio. And then yeah. She does.
Kelsey.
She's amazing.
Hey Kelsey. Hey Kelsey.
So we had to end it off on a high note and a happy note, and that's Fratpack to Matata, which is a very, very drum heavy song. So it was easy for Dale to just get into the pocket of that one. And when you add DJ Temba on that, like DJ Temba is just, he's like the thread that holds everything together, because if anything messes up, like, he's just right there to catch everything. So that was just awesome. And Fratpack to Matata, it's like us being proud of how we speak from where we're from, because it's a cover, and so to that thing, it's like really hard on the tongue. The R's are really, really hard. So it was just an ode to where we come from in terms of how we speak. So that's why we ended it on that note, just to show you again where we from, as well as ended on a light note and a happy note, but a dope note.